أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن شاء الله تعالى we continue reading from رياض الصالحين في باب فضل البكاء من خشية الله تعالى وشوقا إليه. The chapter of crying or weeping out of خشية الله سبحانه وتعالى, awe of Allah سبحانه وتعالى, وشوقا إليه, and looking for meeting him سبحانه وتعالى. قال الله تعالى ويخرون للأذقان يبكون ويزيدهم خشوعا. وقال تعالى أفمن هذا الحديث تعجبون وتضحكون ولا تبكون. وعن ابن مسعود رضي الله عنه قال قال للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم اقرأ علي القرآن. قلت يا رسول الله أقرأ عليك وعليك أنزل. قال إني أحب أن أسمعه من غيري. فقرأت عليه سورة النساء حتى جئت إلى هذه الآية فكيف إذا جئنا من كل أمة بشهيد وجئنا بك على هؤلاء شهيدا. قال حسبك الآن. فالتفت إليه فإذا عيناه تذرفان أي تدمعان. الله سبحانه وتعالى says in سورة الإسراء ويخرون للأذقان يبكون ويزيدهم خشوعا. They will come down to the ground on their faces weeping, and this will increase them in awe of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah says in Surah An-Najm, أَفَمِنْ هَذَا الْحَدِيثِ تَعْجَبُونَ وَتَضْحَكُونَ وَلَا تَبْكُونَ. Are you getting astonished from this revelation? And you are laughing and you are not weeping? And Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu said, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked me, Abdullah, recite the Quran for me. And Abdullah radiallahu anhu said, oh Messenger of Allah, should I recite the Quran for you and it was revealed to you? Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, yes, I love to hear it from someone else. Then Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu started reciting from Surah An-Nisa, Surah number 4, women, until he reached the ayah, فَكَيْفَ إِذَا جِئْنَا مِنْ كُلِّ أُمَّةٍ بِشَهِيدٍ وَجِئْنَا بِكَ عَلَى هَؤُلَاءِ شَهِيدًا. And how it will be like when we bring from each community or each faith community a witness for them or against them, and we bring you, O Muhammad, as a witness against them, means against your ummah. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he heard this ayah from Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, he said, can you stop please? And then Abdullah looked at the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the Prophet was weeping, was crying. He had tears in his eyes sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So what do we get from this hadith? We get from the hadith, البكاء من خشية الله سبحانه وتعالى is ibadah. When we cry and weep out of reverence and awe of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is kind of worship. It takes us closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and it is one of the unique status of the seven categories who will be shaded under the shade of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَرَجُلٌ ذَكَرَ اللَّهَ خَالِيًا فَفَاضَتْ عَيْنَاهُ. Someone who remembers Allah when he or she is alone, and they start weeping and crying. So weeping and crying, when we think about our sins that we have committed, weeping and crying when we think how many times we transgressed against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, weeping and crying when we think about sunnah al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and ask ourselves, did we make him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam victorious in our lives? So he will make us victorious in dunya and akhirah. Did we stand by his words sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Did we love his sunnah? Did we imitate him? So when we think about these questions and think about the grave and think about the day of Yawm al-Qiyamah, Jannah and Nar, then we start crying. And those who cry out of awe and fear and reverence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they are the real believers who have soft hearts that will be connected to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then we can see in the hadith, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud reads for the Prophet, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam stops him, and he was crying sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because this ayah was a heavy ayah for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that Allah is telling him, we are getting and bringing from each nation before you a witness who will be witnessing against them. And we will bring you Muhammad to be a witness against your ummah, if they did do good or not, if they followed the guidance or not. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was shedding some tears out of fearing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and hoping that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will inshallah encompass his ummah with his rahmah and forgive them on the day of Yawm al-Qiyamah. So it is a ibadah when we remember Allah, when we remember our sins, to try to weep. And another hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells us about the Quran. When we read the Quran, try to get engaged with the ayat and try to weep. And the Prophet said, if you cannot weep, make yourself weep. If you cannot cry when you read the Quran, make yourself cry. Subhanallah. So this is a connection that we have to establish with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And somebody will say, is crying or weeping something important? It is very important, because it is a sign of the sound heart. Those who have very tough heart, rough manners, they do not cry quite often. And sometimes when we see some people, adults, crying in situations like janazah, something emotional, some other people think that these people are very soft. No, those people are very good. When you cry when reading the Quran, you cry in salah, you cry when you see a janazah, you cry when something bad happens, this means that you have that sound heart that will get affected by the incidents around it. And hopefully it will be affected and getting from khashiyatullah subhanahu wa ta'ala benefits for you and me in dunya and akhirah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among those who have this بكاء from خشية الله سبحانه وتعالى. And we ask him سبحانه وتعالى to give us all a sound heart that will benefit us in dunya by following سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم, and will benefit us in the akhirah by getting admission to جنة الله سبحانه وتعالى. اللهم اجعلنا من الذين يستمعون القول فيتبعون أحسنه. اللهم اجعلنا من الذين يستمعون القول فيتبعون أحسنه. اللهم اغفر لنا ما قدمنا وما أخرنا وما أسررنا وما أعلنا وما أنت أعلم به منا, أنت المقدم وأنت المؤخر وأنت على كل شيء قدير. اللهم إنا نسألك الجنة وما قرب إليها من قول أو عمل, ونعوذ بك من النار وما قرب إليها من قول أو عمل. اللهم اجعلنا من عبيدك السعداء. اللهم أحينا حياة السعداء حياة من تحب بقاءه, وتوفنا وفاة السعداء وفاة من تحب لقاءه. اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا ولمشايخنا ولكل من علمنا ولكل من له حق علينا يا أرحم الراحمين. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون, وسلام على المرسلين, والحمد لله رب العالمين, وجزاكم الله خيرا.